They're off.
PA Harness Week. I am Charlotte, not Steve. I know it can be confusing, and of course, this is the lovely Heather.
How are you?
Hi. It's so weird. I'm actually the dark one.
You know,
usually I have
Steve,
no color.
Steve is usually the dark one, and now I am.
And we're told Steve is on a beach vacation, so he's getting more tan right now as we speak. I'm just getting more pale.
Yeah, that whole concept of him getting tanner, I don't know how comfortable.
It'll be interesting.
Yeah, I am with that, but I guess we'll see next week.
All right, Heather's going to get things started with a great race from Pocono.
Yes, I am. Here we've got non-winner 17,500. Last five starts of purses $20,000. Number three is To Beach's Own, the better's favorite in here, thanks to his step down in class. He's really racing against a lot tougher last time out. Number eight's Abelard Hanover. Also, he's an easier this time, but he's got that really tough eight hole. And then there's number five, Mustang Art. Never got into the race last time out, but he looks for a better trip this time.
They're really humming on the front end. Sky McFly on the drop tonight. Joe Pavia Jr. gets him to the front from third. Here comes To Beach's Own, another back classer, and takes over as the 2-1 favorite for George Knapp. Sky McFly back to second. All-Star Partner is moving up there on the outside, and he brings along Towns Light Hanover. Back on the inside, Mustang Art shuffled back to fifth. Also outside, Mosey Terror. Then it's Verdad seventh. At the end, Long Live Rock and the trailer, Abelard Hanover, about six away. Half mile, 54-3, 28-3 second panel. To Beach's Own dealing with pressure from All-Star Partner, about three quarters of a length away and inching forward. Sky McFly a length and a half back in the pocket. Second over Towns Light Hanover, a bit removed from his cover. And the saving ground, Mustang Art. Third over sixth now. That is hard to see who it is. Covered up there is Verdad on the inside. And outside, Mosey Terror is the one trying to come up. Three quarters, 121-4, 27-1 third panel. It's still To Beach's Own. Sky McFly in his hip pocket. All-Star Partner still pestering. And now Towns Light Hanover winding up three wide. Mustang Art looking for room inside. Top of the stretch, To Beach's Own leads them all by about a length. Sky McFly looking for another move. Mustang Art on the inside. Nobody in the outside closing too well here. To Beach's Own looking to hold tight.
Mustang Art uses his early gate speed, and he's 20-1, so he's super happy to just sit there and yield to Beach's Own. And that horse is just the best in here. To Beach's Own shrugs off a first over competitor, and then he just leads right to the wire in 150-1 with a George Napolitano Jr. in the bike. Mustang Art took second. Verdad rounded out the trifecta.
Perfect. Well, we have to take a quick break, but we'll come right back with more from the Downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono after this.
Here comes captive audience, last seen in the Ben Franklin Free For All Pace.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do. The places you see, the people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things, the incredible things, and the spectacular things that makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
PA Harness Week. We're going back to the Downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono. Heather, the weather was gorgeous, picturesque there this weekend, and some great races on tap.
Absolutely. I am going to cover right now race number 10, non-winners, 25,000, last five, the purse is $24,000. The top three choices in here, they're all taking steps down in class. We've got number seven, Captive Audience. He's the fan's choice, and he just raced in the $500,000 Ben Franklin. Like, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shack, but I'm pretty sure that's a step down in class, okay? Just, you know, going for that by saying it. Also, number one is Bushwhacker. He was in the graduate at the Meadowlands, another step down in class for him. And then number three, Sparky Mark. He's been racing in the open, and that's been on the Pennsylvania circuit.
Here comes Captive Audience, last seen in the Ben Franklin Free For All Pace. Gets to the front for Jim Morrill Jr. as the 3-2 shot. Bushwhacker back to second. Sparky Mark, another one on the drop, is third now, about four off the pace. And another 2.5 to better's Glass. Fifth on the inside is Humility as they stay single file through the front. Ideal Matters sixth. He begins to rev up on the outside behind Humility. Blatantly Best also out there along with Grab Your Keys, Account Rollover Trails. The half 54-2, 27-3. Second panel, Captive Audience burning it up on the front end here, leading by a length and a half. Bushwhacker is hanging around in a loose pocket there. Sparky Mark is third, still has nobody on his outside. Humility is striving first over, but not making too much happen, about five off the lead. Then on the inside, you've got Better's Glass, Blatantly Best, second over sixth. And then further back to Ideal Matters, Grab Your Keys and Account Rollover the Deep Trailer. Three quarters, 121-4, 27-2, third panel. Captive Audience going an impressive mile here, but hasn't been able to shake Bushwhacker yet. Sparky Mark now has room. He might have the inside open up. He will there, third. Top of the stretch, Captive Audience put to the test now by Bushwhacker on the outside. Captive Audience finding more. Bushwhacker is all out here trying to get past, not going to get there. It's Captive Audience and Jim Morrill Jr.
While Captive Audience does work on the front, Bushwhacker is just sitting on his back, but those fractions are pretty outrageous, and you know that there's going to be a fight when they're going for the wire. Bushwhacker comes home in 26-4, but Captive Audience, he's totally hangs on to get the win by just a neck, but he still gets the win, right? 148-4. Okay, the winning drivers, Jimmy Morrill Jr., Bushwhacker, he grabbed the place money, Sparky Mark took third.
Perfect. Those weren't the only exciting races, though, going on this week. Of course, we had the annual Youth Harness Foundation camp that now the campers usually come and they get to learn everything from taking care of the horses, to cleaning up after them, to driving them, all of the not so pretty stuff, but they seem to love it. These kids come back year after year and they love the camp.
Yeah, they really do. The Harness Horse Youth Foundation is this unbelievable foundation,
yeah.
This group. I always get a little bit choked up talking about them because you can't put a price on what they do. They get the next generation interested in harness racing, and they do so much work. They do scholarships, they do the camps, they put things out to schools, like all kinds of publications. But the camps, people really like the camps because, well, first of all, you can send your kid away to clean stalls for 5 days. I mean, how great is that? You know?
And the kids coming back.
And they
come from all over. Uh-huh. You know, some of the kids I've met from all different states, they come from across the country, and they really love it. And it was very hot last week, but I bet they didn't mind at all. They seem to just love it.
No, they absolutely do. And the ones that graduate from the camp 1 year, like you said, they actually come back and they help again. Mm-hmm. They do anything from cleaning the stalls, the water buckets, they learn how to harness horses. Now remember, the horses that they work with are called these trotting bred ponies. So they're not these gigantic horses where the parents are a little bit, you know, like uneasy.
Almost down to their size
a
little bit.
Down to their size, but they do everything a horse you would see like on, you know, at a harness racing racetrack. But the best part about this camp, of course, is the last evening of the camp, they actually get to drive in a race.
Just so exciting.
Yes. Yeah.
It's so exhilarating for these kids.
Yeah. They go behind the gate. They go right on the racetrack, no matter where they are. I mean, whether they're at Harrington Raceway, the Downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono. So anyway, there were three races at the Pocono camp.
And they're pretty impressive.
They were. So check this out. You've got the kids sitting with the professional drivers, and they go around the racetrack. Mm-hmm. And we've got, in the first race that was won, Zara Chitalia. She won with a royal attire, and she got help from Marcus Miller.
Nice. And then the second race, Mackenzie DuPont. Of course, a horse, CD's Miss M, and she won with the help of Tom Jackson. A great race there.
Now, the final race, the third race, was won by Hunter Ferrero. Now, this was the only boy at the camp, the only boy among all these girls. So, of course, he had something to prove here. He won again with CD's Miss M. Some of the ponies, they race twice in a day. Joe Pavia Jr. was in the bike with Hunter. I do want to give a big shout out to my son, Wyatt Beaver, who trained down CD's Miss M.
Wow.
I know, isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Yay, Wyatt. we got CD's Miss M at our farm a couple weeks before the whole, you know, harness racing youth league camp started. And Wyatt jogged CD's Miss M, so he really got her in shape. So
bravo, and she won twice. Way to go.
Yes, she did.
Perfect. Well, coming up, we're sticking with right here at Harris, Philadelphia. We have a lot of great races to show you. Heather's got those highlights. Stay with us.
Somewhere in LA, overcomes the far outside post to take the lead.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do, the places you see, the people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things, the incredible things, and the spectacular things that makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
Welcome back. You're watching PA Harness Week. We're going to take away the greatest races from this past weekend here at Harris, Philadelphia. You've got race number 5 on tap.
Yes, I do. It's the non-winners of 20,000 last 5. The purse is $22,000. Number 5 is Fool Me Once, the race favorite. Fastest time and the most money made this year in this field. Number 8 is Somewhere in LA, lightly raced, just 6 starts so far for 2015. Number 3 is General Patton, goes behind the gate for trainer Linda Toscano.
8 lengths front from back this single file, just about at the half. Somewhere in LA gets that station in 55. They race up the back stretch, 28 3/4 speed for Somewhere in LA. Fool Me Once right there, second, a length and a half back to General Patton, who's under tap. Urging now. Steelhead Hanover stays to the inside. Sweet Talking Satin emerges first over. He's got 5 lengths of work to do. Then we go 3.5 lengths back to Best Jet Yet, who needs to pick up his ball game. And Stars Above is trailed throughout around the far turn. 3/4, 122-2. And Somewhere in LA leads it by a length over Fool Me Once, who tightens down. Sweet Talking Satin starting the stall 3 wide. Here comes Steelhead Hanover up the inside. General Patton saves valuable ground. They straighten away. Somewhere in LA turns first, but Fool Me Once is out for the drive. General Patton gains up the inside. Fool Me Once is grinding. Somewhere in LA is countering up the inside. General Patton down to the finish. Scott Zeron sweeps the early pick 3.
Somewhere in LA, like I'm thinking Rodeo Drive.
Yes,
although,
that's
exactly. That's technically Beverly Hills, but whatever. We'll take it's in the vicinity. We're just going to go with that, right? All right. So anyway, he works his way to the front. Looks really in command going by the 3/4 pole in 122-2, but he gets caught in the stretch by Fool Me Once, who has the garden spot journey up to Fool Me Once, driven by Scott Zeron. 149-4, a nice fast mile there. Somewhere in LA was second. General Patton was third, and I'm
on a
roll.
I think you want to do another one. She wants to do another one.
Here I go. I'm on a roll. You know what? This is so nice because Steve, he's always jumping in when I'm talking.
I'm just going to let her speak. She's doing a great job.
Thank you. Stick with it.
Race number 12.
Non-winners of 15,000 last 5. The purse is $18,000. Number 6 is KR's Power Surge, getting the most play and has had the most wins in this group for the season. Now we've got number 5, Kaylee's Shake and Bake. We had KR's before.
Now
we've got Kaylee's Shake and Bake. I just love this name because I love that Will Ferrell movie.
Yeah.
Talladega Nights. It's my favorite one. Shake and Bake. And then number 3 is Nova Artist, super classy pacer. He's been a multiple horse of the year at Dover Downs.
Nova Artist up by a length, over the pocket sitting, ooh, bad boy. Good Benz is staying home third. KR's Power Surge mustering up first over Courage fourth. Up on the outside, second up Kaylee's Shake and Bank. Inside, Quick Jolt is pinned in sixth. Outside, China King joins the outer flow. And Ibni Away trails the field. Around the far turn they go, but Nova Artist extends. Opens up to a 3-length lead by 3/4 and 123-3. 27 for the split, and Nova Artist is trying to get away. Oh, bad boy's 3.5 behind now. Outside, KR's Power Surge towards the inside. Good Bet looking for room. They straighten the way for the stretch drive. And Nova Artist still leads by 3.5. Oh, bad boy's in pursuit. Off the cones, Good Bet. Up the inside, Quick Jolt. They come down to the finish. Nova Artist, a well-rated winner.
Nova Artist is an 8-year-old who really lets his class shine through. Here he wins in 151, doing all the work on the front. And this is a family affair horse. The driver's Allan Davis. Now his brother Martin is the trainer, and then their parents Eddie and Kathy Davis own the horse.
All in the family.
All in the family. That's right. Good Bet was a good bet if you bet him for second, and then right there for third. Oh, bad boy.
Okay. Well, Heather, even though Steve's not here, I'm gonna take it over. We've got Blast for the Past. What did he say, you whippersnappers? Heather, together. So this blast from the past is from 1962. I wasn't alive yet, but that's okay. Maybe Steve was. He's not here. The Messenger Stakes. It was from Roosevelt Raceway. And get this, 37,000 fans in 1962 watching this race. There was an upset brewing. Lehigh Hanover was expected to win, but would he win?
The richest harness race of all time gets underway at Westbury, Long Island, and 37,000 have made Lehigh Hanover second favorite to undefeated Andorra's Dream. The purse is 170,000, with 85,000 to the horse home first. In the back near the rail is number 10, Thor Hanover, a 70-1 long shot, who is going to be the Cinderella horse here tonight. However, the backers of Andorra's Dream don't seem to be worried this early in the race. He shares the lead back and forth with other horses, and when they come into the stretch, it's Andorra's Dream and Lehigh Hanover who look like one and two. Watch that horse move on the outside. That's number 10. It's Thor Hanover, and he moves like the wind to overtake and pass the leaders to cop first money. Thor Hanover pays that hefty price to his backers as he scores the harness upset of the year.
So that was a crazy race because we have Lehigh Hanover, the favorite, and then Andorra's Dream was going for 14 wins in a row. All right, but neither one of them ended up winning, right? It's Thor Hanover. Get this, 70-1 pays $144, yeah, with John Simpson Sr. as the driver. By the way, this was the richest race at the time, the richest race. It was $170,000.
Wow.
It goes in 201 and 2. Yeah.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah, right? For 1962,
yeah.
Right?
Well, we have to take a quick break again, but coming back, we're going to go to the Meadowlands. We're going to look at the Meadowlands Pace Elims. Some great races coming up.
Wakizashi Hanover rolls to the lead, but here is Wiggle It, Jiggle It on the outside.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do, the places you see, the people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things, the incredible things, and the spectacular things that makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of Life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
We're here at Harris, Philadelphia, but we're going to take you now to the Meadowlands Pace Elims in this first race, Heather. Two very big names in the sport racing.
Absolutely, yes. In this first elim going for $50,000, we have number 4, ArtSpeak, and number 2 in the Arsenal, Top Pacers. They've raced in like the most competitive races for 3-year-old pacing colts this year. And I mean, they've been competitive themselves. I mean, these are huge races where they've been main competitors. Our favorite is ArtSpeak. He's a 2-year-old colt pacer of the year for 2014. But then there's in the Arsenal, who won the Art Rooney this year. The rest are double digits.
Striding out here in the Arsenal, assumes command, takes control over ArtSpeak, who settles in the pocket spot behind of those two. Past the opening quarter, Delta Winner gaps in third. And then it's Dude's the Man in fourth, followed by Hurricane Ali, Revenge, Shark, and Pierce Hanover, 27-2. Down the backstretch, single file in the Arsenal. Paves the way here, 5-2 with Sears. ArtSpeak, content for a two-hole ride. Delta Winner is third. It's Dude's the Man fourth. Hurricane Ali with a peek to the outside. Then Revenge, Shark, and Pierce Hanover, seventh. No changes, single file. In the Arsenal, steps it off here by a length. ArtSpeak, a two-hole ride. The half are rated 56-1, 28-4. And in the Arsenal, lets out a notch now by a length and a half on ArtSpeak. Here comes Dude's the Man first up to challenge. Delta Winner stays in fourth to the outside of Hurricane Alley, fifth. About 3/8 out now, then Revenge, Shark, and Pierce Hanover. Heading to 3/4, the pace picks up now. In the Arsenal, striding out. He's accelerating away, leads it by 2.5. ArtSpeak on the inside needs to pick it up. Dude's the Man on the outside, third, as they pass 3/4 in 1:23 and 3:27.2. Third quarter by In the Arsenal. And he sprints off by 3 In the Arsenal. Dude's the Man, ArtSpeak on the inside, full out here. Then Delta Winner to the outside, Revenge, Shark all the way In the Arsenal. Came to play.
In the Arsenal has proven that he's so not crazy about being in the hole. He wants to be right on the top, and that's exactly what he does. He cuts out the fraction, and really, he totally gets his own way here, and he busts home in 25-3. Just cannot be caught, wire to wire, and 149-1, and the bike is Brian Sears. For trainer Kelvin Harrison, Delta winner, he closed the fastest in 25 seconds flat, but he just couldn't get there. He took second. Dudes, the man was third. Art Speak finished fourth. Now we're going to head up to the Meadowlands winner circle to hear from the connections.
Brian, you are intent on the lead here.
Well, a couple weeks ago when I was in the too old Art Speak, sometimes he just gets a little uncomfortable in the hole when they're not going quite enough. And when I can just let him do his thing on the front, he's much better off. And the fact that I could get him in behind me worked out really good tonight.
All right, Heather, and the big races just keep coming. Wiggle it, jiggle it. Waukesha Hanover, a big rivalry rematch in this next one.
Yes, this is another pace elimination. By the way, congratulations on pronouncing Waukesha Hanover correctly. I love it. You're my new BFF. All right. So here we go. Number 7 is Wiggle It Jiggle It. Number 6 is Waukesha, going head to head. And people love the battle between these two because they're both trained in little old Delaware, but they're huge when it comes to gameness and when it comes to speed and talent. Wiggle It Jiggle It coming off a really big Max Hemp win at Pocono. And then you've got Waukesha Hanover. He's the North America Cup champion up in Canada. The rest double digits.
Lions' Levi Lewis in front here with Gingras got a strong hold of him. He's fired up on the iron. Bad IOU Hanover is second. First quarter was 26-4, and Campbell moves now with Roland and Rock. The undefeated colt just floats right up there and takes the lead easily. Waukesha Hanover looks at it from fourth, and he's anxious there, trading up his next in fifth. Wiggle It Jiggle It from off the pace, tips to the outside and fed racetrack by Montrell Teague, then two lengths to Rock and Roll World. It's Roland and Rock, and climbing all over Campbell's back is the four, Lions' Levi Lewis. Here comes Waukesha Hanover up with the live cover, Wiggle It Jiggle It, 55-2. A big breather in the second quarter from the inside. Bad IOU Hanover is fourth. Around the far turn, Wiggle It Jiggle It to the outside, and then on the rail, trading up, followed by Rock and Roll World. Heading around the far turn, pulling pocket was Lions' Levi Lewis, up and after Roland and Rock. From the inside, Bad IOU Hanover gaps the pocket. Waukesha Hanover sets up a rally, starts to roll three deep, and he's tracked intently by Wiggle It Jiggle It with the off-the-pace move, then trading up in the turn for home. Rock and Roll World, the trailer, 122-3 for three quarters in the stretch drive. Waukesha Hanover rolls to the lead, but here is Wiggle It Jiggle It on the outside. The two favorites square off. Wiggle It Jiggle It on the outside. Inside Waukesha Hanover. Wiggle It Jiggle It. Wiggle It Jiggle It, 1-5. Wiggle It Jiggle It. Waukesha Hanover.
Okay, a lot going on here. First, a bunch leap really early, and Lions' Levi Lewis, he sets off the first teletimer. Then Roland and Rock. He shipped in from Iowa, by the way. He was 18-18 career wins.
Wow.
Going into this. He takes over by the half, but then, you know, there's just this huge charge from the back of the pack. We've got Waukesha pacing up, Wiggle It Jiggle, it's right behind him. When they get down the stretch, here it is. Here is that duel everybody wants to see. Wiggle It Jiggle It, he experimented with something he doesn't ever do. He comes from the back of the pack. So this is, he just proved his versatility here. He ends up winning in 148-4. You know, it was a close one. Both of those guys, a lot of heart there. But Montrell Teague in the sulky, he gets it done. Wiggle It Jiggle It is trained by Clyde Francis, owned by Montrell's dad, George Teague. You always want to make your dad happy, especially if he's the owner of the horse. Waukesha Hanover was second. Rock and Roll World was third. By the way, tonight, $700,000 Meadowlands Pace Final. We do want to tell everybody that, so make sure you tune in for the Meadowlands Pace Final. You know, go to simulcasting outlets or head up to the Meadowlands. So now we're going to send it to Bob Hollywood Hayden with the winners.
Before the race, I kind of decided to take back, but it kind of worked out perfect when I seen everybody up on the gate and rushing out of there. Made my mind up really quick.
And this is the first time you got a chance to show what you guys could do from off the pace. Take us to the top of the stretch.
I had plenty of horse. I mean, I was raging over the top of Timmy. I pulled him off of him, and right when he seen that horse in front of him, he just went right up on there, and I popped the earplugs, and he went zoom right on by.
So we've seen a great horse on the front end, but he might even be a touch better off the pace.
We always thought that. Training down, we always did both, 50-50. And Dad liked him better off the pace. I liked him better on the front when we had the hood cutout, so we can see a horse, but he's very versatile. He can do it either way.
All right, Heather, also at the Meadowlands, the Graduate Series Final, 250 thou on the line. I'll take it.
Or not Steve bad. Would say 250 clams. I think he says that sometimes. Right. So in honor of you, Steve.
We'll go with the clams.
We'll go with the clams. Yeah, exactly. Number six is J.L. Cruz, a $50,000 supplement in this series, and he is the race favorite. He's coming off a win in the Sun Invitational at Pocono. Number seven, Father Patrick, a two-time Dan Patch Award winner. You know, he's been beat a couple times by J.L. Cruz, but still, Father Patrick can't be discounted. One more horse worth mentioning. Number four, Shake It Carry. She's in the mix. Last year's overall trotter of the year beat out the boys in the United States.
It's Goral Hanover and Matt Kekalia there in 26-3. Goral Hanover in front. Here comes J.L. Cruz, a methodical move to the outside, and he strides up and takes charge now with authority for Campbell in the backstretch. Opulent Yankee now gaps in third. It's Resolve. He is gapped in fourth here. Father Patrick is parked on the outside, stalled now fifth. Rompaway Galaxy sixth on the inside. Then Shake It Carry and Made Well Hanover. They're at the half mile. J.L. Cruz is the best there in 54 2/5. 27-4 second quarter. J.L. Cruz in front. Goral Hanover at two-hole ride. Opulent Yankee is third to the outside. Here comes Father Patrick now getting in gear. Fourth now third. Gathering steam there with Shake It Carry trying to catch up to that cover. Pinned in is Resolve near the back of the pack with Madewell Hanover and Rompaway Galaxy. But it's J.L. Cruz with the technical advantage here. Father Patrick comes calling on the outside, looking for an off-the-pace move tonight. Goral Hanover on the inside, third, three quarters, 1:22-4. They're in the stretch of the Graduate. And it's J.L. Cruz, and he's strong, and he's in front by 2.5-3. J.L. Cruz, Father Patrick, not tonight. Shake It Carry, the mare and Tactor getting in gear late. Resolve on the outside, but Cruz is still the king. J.L. Cruz.
Goral Hanover trots to the top first. J.L. Cruz took over from there and just holds off all the challenges with John Campbell on the bike, even the challenge by Shake It Carry. And that girl is trotting her little legs off. Oh, she's gorgeous. I love her to death, but J.L. Cruz does win by a nose, not just a nose. A world record nose, a trotter. You know, for all you people out there that have been following harness racing for a long time, a 1:49-4 record here on
impressive.
A mile track. Yes, this is the fastest trot race in the history of the Meadowlands.
Wow.
The fastest trot race on a mile ever. So you just saw it take place. Obviously, the last Shake It Carry was second. Resolve was third.
All right, well, unfortunately, all good things must come to an end, including this show. We have to say goodbye, but remember, tonight at the Meadowlands, the Pace Final, it's going to be huge. Wakasashi Hanover, who this one's rooting for. She's hoping for a win. We will see. And it's been so much fun standing alongside you.
Let me just clarify, the reason I'm rooting for Wakasashi Hanover, and I have to make this a point in like which you already know, but I'm going to say it anyway. My mom, Joanne King, is the trainer.
Yes.
So I have a legit reason for playing favorites. You
got to cheer on mom.
But of course, there's Wiggly Jigglet in the Arsenal is going to be in there. So it's going to be a great race.
Yeah.
Got to go somewhere and watch it.
Well, it's been fun.
It has been fun.
I always like being on this lady. Steve, we wish you were here, but honestly, it's been fun having Girls Day. We'll see you guys later. Tune in next week.